Hi guys, all of you have worked on this Azure Data Factory, and most of you always thought of like how much it cost. You never mind it, or you never know the right calculation for it. So in this video, I will going to give you the very basic tip for reducing your Azure Data Factory running cost up to a 50%. Yes, up to 50% by doing just one small change, which most of the people don't understand. So I am Deepak Goyal, having 13 years of experience in IT, and I am Azure certified solution architect. So I'll take you through this small change which can help you to increase your cost effectiveness of your Azure Data Factory, and you can impress your manager right away. So let's begin the video. So you can see that this is my Azure Data Factory account, where I have this copy pipeline. Copy pipeline is one of the most common activity which people have. Okay, so basically you use Azure Data Factory for copying data from one data source to the other data source, like from your CSV file to maybe on Azure SQL database you want to put, or maybe anything like that. When you create a copy activity, you use source, you use sync, and then at some point of time, you might have used the mapping as well. But near to it, a very important tab, that is settings tab. If you go to the settings tab, you will see like this. You will be charged of use DIOs, copy duration, so and so. So I just give you one short description. What does DIU hours base? So DIU is data integration unit hours. That based on this, it will cost you the amount by the Microsoft Azure. So this DIU is defined by your integration runtime. In integration runtime, you can have a large processor or large memory based servers. So depending upon what kind of power you wanted, so the more power you need, the more DIU you will exhaust and the more you have to pay. So lesser the DIU, lesser will be the cost and lesser will be your bill. So by default, you keep most of the time it's auto. And when somebody says this data integration unit as an auto, it will take up as a 4 data DIUs. That by default, it will take as your 4 integration unit servers. Because this is the default setting by your Microsoft Azure, and it can increase up to 4, 8, 10, and so on. 4, 8, 16 and all. So you should go and keep it as 2. This will make sure that you will reduce down the cost by half. Yes, literally half. Because sometimes your pipeline is running a small chunk of a data and you don't have so much large size. Maybe in case of your incremental pipelines, which runs on daily basis or hourly basis. In those cases, you don't need it so much power. So you can set it 2. And by default, it will get increased up as and when needed. So it will start with the 2. If you keep it as an auto, it will start taking it as a 4 minimum. So that's how you can reduce down your Azure Data Factory running cost by half. Besides this, the one another important point which nobody tells you is, if you have a pipeline which you are not running, then unused pipeline also cost you like almost $1 per month. So assume that you have 10 developers, and just for it in their development environment, they've created like 10 pipelines each. So there may be 100 pipeline they have created, which is just for like their development purpose only, and which is not used. So that 100 unused pipeline is costing as $100 per month to the organization, and eventually it will be like $1,200 a year, which is somewhere around like 1 lakh rupees a year. So you can save this much amount of cost easily just by removing all those pipelines which you don't need at all. Besides this, also there are a couple of other techniques to improve your Azure Data Factory pricing. For that, you can go on to this a very good tutorial where you can find all those pricing calculator, how you can decrease the prices and how you can identify what is the cost of your pipeline running. I will drop down the link of this URL in the comment section below. So you can go and have a look. And by this, we are reaching to the end of this video. If you like the video, please press the like icon. And if you're new to this channel, please do subscribe the channel if you haven't subscribed yet. So till then, goodbye. Keep learning.